Hi! In this video, I'll show you how you can use the vector element in ZeroBlock to create a website. Let's take this page as an example. First, let's draw an illustration for the hero section using the vector editor. I click the plus button and add vector. Now in the editor, let's remove the default element and draw the illustration using the draw tool. I'll create some waves, just like that. Now, using the Edit and Bend tools, let's modify it. A double click on a point makes the angle smoother, but I don't want it so large. Now, when the outline is ready, let me fill it with color and remove the stroke. On top of each wave, I'll add some foam. The waves and the foam will interact with the website not like separate elements, but as a single illustration. That's why I'll create them within a single vector. Let me duplicate the foam using the Option key for Mac and Alt for Windows. To avoid similar shapes, I'll slightly modify the foam for each wave. To do this, I'll add new anchor points using the Draw tool. A double click on the point sharpens the angle. Let me modify the points using the Edit tool. Rotate the shape and adjust the segments with the Bend tool. Done! The illustration is ready. That's what it looks like on the hero section. Vectors are very useful when it comes to creating small design elements on the website. Let's add another line to the menu so it appears when visitors hover over it. First, let me delete the default element and, using the Draw tool, let me make an unclosed outline that fits the length of the selected menu item. I'll make it look like a wave. Then, set the color. Nice, the vector is ready. Now, using the animation, let's make the underline effect on hover. To animate the underline, in the element settings, click the Add button under Step-by-Step Animation. Here, I set the event for the animation effect, on hover. Under Trigger, let's specify the element which will run the animation effect when you hover over it. Click Add Trigger and then select the menu item. Now, let's set the animation itself. For the step 1, I set the duration and opacity to 0, since initially we don't see the element on the page. The second step makes the underline visible, so I set how quickly it will appear, for example, 0.3 seconds. Opacity is 100%. Now let's make such underline for every menu item. I duplicate the wave and slightly adjust it to the new menu item. Now I need to change the trigger. For this, I open the animation settings, delete the previous trigger, and select the correct one. Okay, I added the decor elements for each menu item. Here's what it looks like on the published page. If you already have an SVG file, you can import it into the Tilda vector editor to quickly modify it. This is handy for a block with special offers, where the copy may often change. It would be nice to edit the shape immediately in ZeroBlock. Let me import the SVG file that I prepared for this copy. I send it to back and change the copy. As the text is longer now, I need to adjust the shape to it. Let me quickly do it right in ZeroBlock. The vector editor makes it easy to work with shapes and hand-drawn elements. Let's see how you can use it to fine-tune your page. You can add underlines on hover, illustrations, strokes, arrows, decor stripes, backgrounds, overlay graphics, and more. These are only some of the ideas to use this tool. Get creative and design unique websites. For a detailed guide on how to work with vector elements, check out the Tilda Help Center. You'll find the link in the description. Thanks for watching and good luck!